When Ali radiallahu anhu gave his first khutbah, what did he say? And this was an amazing time, because this was a time of great fitna and difficulty. After the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no other difficulty was greater than the assassination of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And Ali radiallahu anhu was appointed as the Khalif. And what did he do? What did he say? This first khutbah, this is all he said. He ascended the pulpit. And he said, "Oh believers, you are in need of a rajul fa'ala qawwal. You are in need of a man of actions and not of a person who just talks. Because if revolutions and change came through talking, me and you would have a revolution every hour. Because me and you are very good at talking. But the help of Allah does not come through talking. It comes through the actions of individuals. If you want the mercy of Allah to descend, if you want the help of Allah to descend, then you have to do actions. You have to perform actions. Because this is when the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends." And Ali radiallahu anhu said, "Oh people, you are in need of a rajulun fa'al, an action man. Not of people who just talk. Not of people who just talk. If we want the mercy of Allah to descend, if we want the help of Allah to descend, we have to translate our talking into actions." You know, how often do you hear Muslims complaining, "Oh, why isn't the help of Allah descending?" How often do you hear them whinging? But how many actions do we do? Has this ummah paid its zakah and then Allah withheld its help? Has this ummah prayed salah like it should have prayed and then Allah withheld its help? Has this ummah made the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam their role model, then Allah withheld its help? Has this ummah made people like Abu Bakr and Umar and Khadija and Fatima their role models and then Allah withheld its help? Has this ummah had the concern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Has it a concern for the rest of humanity and then Allah withheld his help? Or do we have this warped perception that somehow Allah is obliged to help us? Somehow, na'udhu billah, as though we are Allah and Allah is our slave. Understand, you are the slaves. Allah is samad, Allah is dependent. You have to fulfill the conditions and then the help of Allah descends. That's when the help of Allah descends. Not that you do nothing and you go on lackadaisically in your lives. Dunya is your maqsid. You don't learn anything about your deen. And somehow Allah is obliged to help you. Allah is the Lord. Allah is Khaliq. Allah is Malik. Allah does not require to help anybody. And your numbers don't make any difference. You can be 1.6 million, 1.2 billion. They don't make any difference. Your power, your wealth doesn't make any difference. What counts in the eyes of Allah is your quality, not your quantity. Your substance. And this is why Allah says, "Kam min fi'atin qalilatin ghalabat fi'atin kathiratan bi'idhnillah." How often do you see that a small group of people, a small regiment defeats a large regiment? Why? With the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the time of Khalid bin Walid, in the battle of Yarmouk, this was the ultimate battle. After this day, the Christians never came into the Arab Peninsula. The Muslims were 41,000. And the conservative estimate of the Romans were that they were 140,000. And Khalid bin Walid was checking his ranks. He was checking his men. And he walked past this young soldier who was looking at the Roman soldiers and their army. And he marveled at their numbers and how much weapons they had. And he said, "How many are the Christians and how few are the Muslims?" And Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu said, Don't say that. For say, "How many are the Muslims and how few are the Romans and the Christians?" Because weakness comes from being forsaken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Weakness comes from being forsaken by Allah. If you lose Allah, you lose everything. You lose everything. And if you attain the one Allah, you have everything. After the battle of the Murtaddin, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu told Khalid bin Walid, "Now the superpower of the day, the superpower, the Persians are waiting." And he said, "Go and deal with them, but allow your men, those who want to go home, because they fought many battles, to go home." And Khalid bin Walid made the announcement. He has 13,000 men. Out of those 13,000 men, 11,000 decided to go. He only had 2,000 men and he was going to face the superpower, the Persians. And he wrote a letter to Umar ibn Khattab. And he said, "O Amir al-Mu'mineen, I've only got 2,000 men left." And Umar and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu sent a reinforcement in the shape of how many men? He sent a reinforcement in the shape of one person, Qaqa ibn Amr, for 11,000 men. And the Sahaba said, "Oh Abu Bakr, what are you doing? What are you doing? 11,000 men and you are replacing them with one man?" And he said, "Yes, because those ranks which have the likes of Qaqa ibn Amr will never be forsaken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because these were men of substance. And by Allah, these people were never forsaken by Allah. You never had the concept of Guantanamo Bay, Belmarsh. You were never humiliated in the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. One Muslim prisoner was humiliated in the Byzantine lands. And the news reached Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. And Umar ibn Abdul Aziz wrote a letter to the governor and he said, "Before you place this letter down, free that Muslim prisoner, for by Allah I will send an army which begins here and ends where you are." There was never a time, really, there was never a time like what happened in Israel and Palestine in the time of Mu'tasim. One Muslim lady was slapped in the Byzantine lands and she cried out, "Wa Mu'tasima." And the Romans began to laugh and they said, "Why are you calling Mu'tasim? He's thousands of miles away. You think he's going to jump on his black and white horse and come and save you?" And the news reached Mu'tasim. The news reached Mu'tasim. And Mu'tasim sent an entire army for the izzah of one Muslim lady. And he told every single one of them, he said, "Each one of you climb, and when you go, go on a black and white horse."